Asher,
Kiddushanu,
Mizmotov,
Vitzivanu,
Likpoa,
Mezuzah.
Amen!
I hope I'm not talking out of turn, but I just wanted to, 30 seconds here, but...
Time's up.
Really, this is a historic moment for the community here in downtown. Certainly for those that are familiar with the history of this neighborhood and the progress that it's made. So the fact that such a powerful and important organization has chosen to make its home in this location, in this area, is really of tremendous, tremendous significance. But I just want to share something very, very short from my heart to all of you that are here. And I actually shared this at the synagogue over the high holidays, but we were talking about the idea of anti-Semitism. And in the Bible, the first time that we find somebody responding to anti-Semitism, we find Moses. There is an incident where while he was still a prince, a young prince growing up in the palace of Pharaoh, he sees an Egyptian beating a Jew. And so he makes the choice to step in, and in self-defense, he takes the life of the Egyptian. And the rabbis argue about what means he used to take the life of the Egyptian. And they offer three opinions. One of them says he used his fist, which makes sense. The other one says he used a shovel. And the third one says he mentioned God's name. He said a holy name of God, and immediately the Egyptian fell to the floor. Now, the truth is, what is the difference how Moses responded? If he used his fist, if he used the shovel, or if he used the name of God. But in fact, this discussion among the rabbis has tremendous implications today. Everybody here in the room, the fact that you're here means that you understand the situation that we are in as a people, and certainly the nation of Israel, the situation that they are in, and how important each of us are. And so many people respond to the situation by saying that we need to strengthen our fist. Israel has invested heavily in an incredible military, probably one of the best in the world, and they continue to invest in R&D and weaponry, etc. And that is certainly very, very important, even only as a deterrent, so that countries know that if they start up with Israel, they will have to reckon with something, with a mighty force. There are others who believe in the shovel, and this is where AIPAC comes in. The shovel is the theory that we need to develop and cultivate relationships and institutions not only in Israel, but all over the world. We need to lobby governments, because it's not only by the fist alone that we shall survive. This organization that has dedicated itself to lobbying, particularly the government of the United States, which is the superpower of the world, any which way you cut it, is a critical part of helping Israel day to day, keeping this relationship very, very strong. But thirdly, and perhaps most importantly, is the third opinion that Moses used the name of God. And this is, in fact, the idea of the scroll. And this is why it's significant that we began this evening by hanging a mezuzah on the door. Because, you know, every cause needs to have a soul. We lobby for Israel. We talk about how important it is. We go to Washington and we write our representatives, you got to support Israel, you got to support Israel. The question is, why do you have to support Israel? This cause needs a soul. This office, as we say, this office needs a mezuzah. If we remember every day and we remind ourselves what is the soul behind our cause, what are we fighting for, what are we protecting, what are we lobbying for, why are we going to Washington, etc., 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 then ultimately we will have tremendous, tremendous success. So let us remember every time we come into this office, we see the mezuzah on the door, this is a very important cause. It's got a soul, and the soul is that the security of the state of Israel, the health of the state of Israel, the health of Israel's lobby is the security of our people. Let's never forget that. We need strong friends everywhere in the world, especially here in the United States. So, l'chaim to everyone, and mazel tov, it's a wonderful occasion.